Hello everybody, my name is H. Here's a RadioShack catalog hardcover, 59th anniversary. Unfortunately the binding is broken, but we got all sorts of vintage goodies in here. Turntables, speakers, combination units, a reel-to-reel machine. Flipping to the cassette deck section. Here's their front cover cassette deck, the highest end one at the time, the SCT-3000. See, it retailed for $600. You can go ahead and read the specifications here if you pause the video, but this was their highest end deck for 1 year, the only drawback being there was no selection for metal tapes. And so this deck was refined in the year 1981. It appeared in the fall 1981 Radio Shack catalog and was made for 1 year. Their highest end cassette deck ever made, the SCT-3100, and here it is, new in box in the year 2018. Now sadly that new in box description does have an asterisk after it. According to the previous owner, he bought this when it was new with an intention to transfer a record collection to cassette, and because of certain circumstances he never got around to it, so this sat in the box for many years till one day he decided to open it up and test it out. Plugged it in and let it run. Sadly, it didn't work. It's suspected to be a belt issue. So we put it back in a box, as far as I know, exactly the way it was taken out. And there it sat ever since, until here it is now. So sadly, I won't be able to demonstrate this because of the known issue, but we can still unbox it. As far as I know, this was boxed up exactly the way it came out. And of course, everything's included in there still. So we have these string things holding it together here. Box is actually in very nice shape. For being 30 years old, I would say. Seems to have been stored in a non-human environment. Relatively temperature controlled as well. So here we have the deck. See, we have some writing on there that says right top, and there's another one in here that says left top. Maybe that's like the previous owner's note to himself on how to box it back up. There's also a piece of hair in there. Here's a pamphlet, presumably this has the manual in it. Sure enough. Also has some other paperwork. The previous owner has included in the auction a Hitachi service manual. He said he could not find a service manual for the 3100, which I'm not surprised by that. It's certainly a rare deck. But this was the closest thing he could find. And Hitachi and realistic cassette decks actually have a lot in common, so hopefully this will be useful. Here's the manual for the actual 3100. It's in mint condition, obviously. Take a quick peek through this here. Looks like we have an overview. Geez, those old audio accessories. I shouldn't say old, I should say vintage. I'm sure they certainly still work just fine. Got Dolby FM calibration and such. Look at the VU meter. That appears to be a picture taken of it with a digital camera. Well, not digital, but a camera. Deep magnetizer and cleaner tapes. That's the manual. And we have the deck itself. It also has some wires. Black and gray, not red and white. Interesting. That looks like everything. And here's the deck itself. Very carefully take the packaging off. got this vintage smell to it. I can smell it already. Old metal smell. Here's the power cord. And it's new enough to still have this on it. They misspelled the word before. That's kind of funny. It appears the counter has not been reset since he tested it 20 years ago, so we'll reset that now. And here it is. Let's get a good view of it here. Actually, I'll lower the camera. Absolutely beautiful condition as expected. Very tiny buttons, but they feel good. Power's on, I'll turn that off. We got timer, record. That's an interesting feature. Got auto rewind. We seem to have a selection for auto rewind, which is kind of neat. Got the counter reset, obviously. And bring it over here. We got bias adjustment. Set that back to zero. And we have a test button. We have all four tape options, including metal. We got all four Dolby options. Tape and source monitor. This is three head. It is also dual capstan. Another test button for record calibration here. Output level and of course the record levels. I'll turn around to the back. I guess we could get some better lighting on there. Got another calibration knob and some audio outputs. This looks like it could have been stamped out and revealed something else underneath there, but they didn't do that. Here's the information. And that's it for the unboxing. So hopefully a belt replacement will get this thing to work. And we'll show it again set up. Thank you for watching.